like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. It's tasty. Why don't we try to sing with the letter A? I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas.
Yum, yum.
I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. Sweet. How about the letter E? I like to eat.
Oh, hey. Hey, you guys. I didn't know you were there. How long have you been watching me? Oh, I just got off of work. Just got back from the grocery store. Picked up a few necessities. So, how was your day today? It was pretty good. Yeah. You know, it's Thanksgiving. Getting ready to go to friends and family. Spend some time. Do some cooking. I'm sure you guys are planning on doing the same. Are you guys cooking at home? Are you going out? Are you making the turkey? Or are you maybe putting together an appetizer or something? Like what you guys got going? Don't mind me, I just wanna finish unpacking here. So I guess as long as I have you here, I can tell you about these fruit that I'm stacking up here. Since this is kind of my, I guess my third episode of the Kelly Jo Eats a Fruit Show. In this case, a lot of fruit. I've talked about these before, if you've watched any of my other episodes. This is the pomegranate. And you guys remember, in the summertime, it would not be unheard of for you to come to my house and see like 8 or 10 watermelons just randomly scattered all over my floor. But as I said to another friend of mine, you know, pomegranates are kind of like my winter watermelon. In the winter, in the fall, you will see, a small handful scattered around my house. They're really good for you, and they're really good. When you get good ones, they're so sweet and they're so delicious, and I eat them with yogurt, and they are just divine. But anyway, but you know what? I don't make any desserts or recipes or anything for Thanksgiving that involve pomegranates. But I kind of want to talk about Thanksgiving, and I don't know, maybe we can go through this together. I've been asked to provide an appetizer for Thanksgiving this weekend, or in 2 days from now. And they said to me, Kelly, why don't you make ceviche? Because you make really good ceviche. So thank you. If anybody doesn't know what ceviche is, it's that, it's like marinated fish. You take fish or shrimp or scallops or whatever, and you put it in lime juice, put in some serrano or jalapeno peppers, put in mango or whatever, but you put it in the lime juice and it marinates and it kind of cooks it in the lime juice. So you don't cook it, it's raw and then it cooks. So it's really good. But anyway, it's really healthy and refreshing and stuff. So they want me to make it, and so that's fine. But last time I made it, I used these little sushi grade little miniature bay scallops. And I don't have any of those, so I had to improvise and think of something new. So I was thinking, okay, in my freezer, I have, let me go get it. Voila, look at this. See what this is? You know what this is? It looks like a paddleboard, like a miniature paddleboard. But no, it's a fish. This is a half of a halibut. No, not a halibut. It's a half of a yellowtail or hamachi. And actually, it's sushi grade too. So I'm thinking I'm going to take this and I'm going to chop it up and I'm going to make ceviche with this. The only problem is it's like frozen solid, which is fine. I could let it thaw. I could just leave it and let it thaw for the next couple of days. But the problem is it's like huge, and I'm not going to make ceviche with all of this. Maybe half of it, and that's going to be plenty. But I'm not going to be able to, like, if I thaw the whole thing, I have to eat the rest of it, and I don't think I can eat it all at once. So what I really want to do is kind of cut it in half, put some of it in the freezer for another time, and then work with what I cut in half. So maybe that's what this show is going to be about. This is going to be the great frozen fish cutting episode. And in a way, I guess if you think about it, we can maybe think of this as sort of like a women's empowerment episode. Because if you know, say you're living alone or whatever, or say your boyfriend or your husband's out, what if you have to do the cooking and you're dealt with a blow like this, like you've got to cut into this fish. What do you normally do? When you have problems that require strength, not brains, strength, you know, like if you have a flat tire, or if you maybe have to change your carburetor, or maybe you have to climb up on a rooftop to fix a little hole in your roof or something, clean the gutters, or, you know, anything that requires like labor, like intensive labor. To me, those are intensive labors, but what do? You usually call in your boyfriend or your spouse, your husband, and you do the oh, I'm so very, very weak and very, very unable to do this by myself. So please, please, will you help me? Will you help me cut this little fishy? Because I can't do it all by myself. See, and we gotta stop that, ladies. We gotta be more empowered. We need to be tougher and stronger. We can do this. We can do stuff on our own without having a man around who can do it for us. You know, quit passing off the hard stuff onto them and just take charge of your life, you know? So here's what I'm thinking. I'm going to put this aside. I'm gonna put this away, and we're gonna go through this together, and we're gonna cut this in half. I'm gonna improvise and just figure out the best way to do it. We're gonna try maybe a thing or two, I don't know. And then we'll just kind of see what happens. And we're not gonna see what happens. I'm gonna show you what happens when a girl takes charge, when there is no man around the house, or maybe he is in the house, but he might be sitting on the sofa with a beer in one hand, the remote in the other, his feet propped up, and, you know, probably burping or something like that. No. He can stay there. He can watch his football. I don't watch football anymore anyway, ever since the Cubs lost. But anyway, so let's do that. But I'm going to have to change because I just got back from work. I can't chop frozen fish in work clothes. So let me put this away, and then I'm going to change into something more appropriate for frozen fish cutting. It's important. It's like a body, mind, spirit sort of thing that you've got to get into. When you're going to take on a challenge that isn't your normal, something you wouldn't normally do, you would pass it off to your other half. You got to just prepare mentally and you know, spiritually and physically and get ready for the occasion. So, and then you can do anything. Nothing can stop you. You can do it. Ladies, we can do it. We can do anything. So, let me put this stuff away. And let's get to it. I got a frozen fish to cut. This goes first. Thank you. do this now? Okay. This is where we bring out the, you know, the macho side, you know, the side that can cut into a frozen fish. We don't need a man.
We can do it.
Okay. So, where's the fish? Okay, there's the fish. So, here's the fish. Let's just get right to it. No more wasting time. Okay. We need a knife. We need a knife. We can't do it with our teeth. And we don't have a chainsaw, and that's what a man would probably use as a chainsaw, but I mean, who can't cut a fish with a chainsaw? We're gonna do it with a knife. Now, I've done some Googling, been researching, and what I learned is they don't recommend that you use like a knife like this, because it's not serrated and you might slip and you might cut yourself. You don't wanna cut yourself. So you wanna do like a serrated knife like that. See? It's all dirty. Anyway, we're gonna try to use it with this. We're gonna try to do it with this one. All right, so I'm just not even gonna kid around because we're wasting some valuable time here. I am not gonna hold it like this because if I slip, I'm gonna cut my fingers off and that's not gonna be a good thing to do. Again, I'm sharing this with you during the Kelly Jo Eats a Fruit show, not because I've run out of fruit to eat, because I love fruit. I can always come up with fruit. But I feel, you know, sometimes us ladies, we don't give ourselves, the benefit of the doubt that we can do some of the stuff that we ask our men counterparts to do, you know? And I just want to empower the woman, especially this Thanksgiving when there's gonna be a big turkey. Maybe you're afraid you can't lift the turkey out of the oven or something. I don't know. You just look outside of the box from this point on. If you would normally have your man cut this, don't, just try it. Try it yourself. That's what we're doing this for. You know, I mean, if you had a neighbor, really buff neighbor, named Pablo, you know, with biceps the size of your head, and you know, who can cut this in half maybe with the tight 8-pack abs of his, then maybe. Whew. Sorry. Shake it off. Shaking it off, Kelly. No, Pablo. Pablo, go home. Go home, Pablo. No, Pablo. Pablo, no. Pablo, I'll call you later. Okay. Anyway, okay, here we go. All right, so now, here's what I'm gonna do. I am going to take this right under my chicken wing, okay? I'm just gonna go like this. See, I think this is the way they would, a guy would probably do it, because then he could show it off his bicep, you know? So I'm just gonna hold it like that. I'm gonna hold it away from the blade, okay? I'm gonna hold it firmly, firm grasp. And the entire time you're cutting, you gotta keep thinking, you can do it. You can do this. Okay. Let's do it. Not too bad. It's wearing me out a little. And my chicken wing is freezing. Oh, it's all red now. I don't really recommend that. Well, this is kind of going a little slow. Not exactly what I was hoping. So we got to think if there's a better way. You need to be resourceful. See, guys, they're resourceful, or, you know, maybe they like you to think they're being resourceful, but, you know, they might have a little manual, like, how to look resourceful for your mate, and they might, like, run into their bedroom or go into the bathroom. You know, they take a long time in the bathroom sometimes. They might be reading the instruction manual on what to do next, like how to change a light bulb or something like that, or carve a turkey or whatever. So, we gotta think outside of the box. Ah, of course. I'm gonna try using my friend here. I'm sure everybody has one of these. When in doubt, when the knife is not sharp enough and you can't get through, You can always use your friend Hawk. This is my friend Hawk. Specifically, he is a M48 Hawk. No girl should be without this. In fact, I'm sure most of you girls probably have one of these, you know, in your sock drawer or something. I don't know. But I use this quite frequently. I use it for shaving. It's really close, especially the ones right here. Anyway, all right, let's see what this does. When in doubt, you be resourceful. Stick that in there. It's starting to jump away from me. Okay. Oh. 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 Oops. Oh, poor thing. I'm slaughtering him. When in doubt, try again. Oh, that's a nice little piece of sushi right there. I could probably eat it. I can eat this raw. Here, I'm gonna try this one. Let's try this again. Poor fish. If it only knew what it died for. See, guys could not have done this any faster. They put on their face like they're working really hard. Like when you can't open like a ketchup jar. I mean, let's be honest. How many times do we actually can open the ketchup jar, but we want them to open it to make them feel, you know, like manly. Well, we're having some trouble here. I don't know. We can do this. We can do this. Yes, we can. And we're going to. We're going to do... Oh, darn. Look at the time. We're all out of time. Oh. Unfortunately, we can't finish this on air, but I'm just going to cut... It'll take a few more minutes, and I'm just going to cut through this, no problem. And I want to make the best of each and ever. It's going to be great. I'll leave a recipe for you on the end of this. But yeah, so no sweat. We can do it. Have a great Thanksgiving, guys. Okay, bye. Hello? Mom? Hi. Hello. I'm good. No, I'm fine. No, I just got off work. Can you do me a favor? Is Dad around? Oh, can you ask him if he can come over here as soon as he can and help me chop up some frozen fish? Yeah, like right away. All right. Okay, thanks. Bye.
I like to eat, eat. Apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat. Apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat. Apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat. Apples and bananas. Oh, it's tasty. Why don't we try to sing with the letter A? I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. Yum yum. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. Mm-hmm.